just the start of the season. It's only three games, so I think you can't get carried away because every game in the league's tough. But yeah, confidence high because we've started well.
A little bit similar to ourselves in the sense that, you know, so many new faces. Obviously, we've been fortunate enough to get off to a good start, but that means nothing unless you continue to play in the same vein and approach the games in the same vein that we've done. It can change very, very quickly. We're very respectful of that.
Good afternoon. Welcome along to Blackpool. It's wet, it's grey, it's raining cats and dogs, and we're moments away from Lincoln to the All in Black taking on Blackpool, who've stuttered a little at the start of this season. Just two goals in their starting 11. Lincoln City have the 10, and Lincoln City have that fine start to the season. But these things, as we all know, count for nothing once the games get underway. And I'm sure Blackpool will be looking to chalk up a win here against the Imps. And it's an Imps side that's a year on from Michael Appleton taking charge. And by my reckoning, just George Grant in this starting 11, as the players take the knee, is amongst those players who were here in the starting 11 in that squad that day. Harry Anderson on the bench, players back up. We're getting ready to get this game underway. The floodlights already very much on as Liam Bridcut clears long downfield. We're in the stand opposite the main stand, and the players, Lincoln players, are kicking towards the right as we look at the game. And if you're watching on iFollow, well, you'll know that because you can see it. And it's City moving it forward, trying to get their passing going quickly. The surface should certainly suit passing as it's long into the Lincoln half, headed away by Jackson in midfield with Bridcut. And then Rowan, who chips it forward, but it can't keep it in play, and it just skips out of play by a big banner that says Tangerine Army, the Seasiders. Sadly, last home game, there were 1,000 Blackpool fans in the ground. There are very, very few, just a few directors here today. Steve Thompson alongside me. Tomo, thoughts?
Yeah, well, just waiting for the game to settle, really. We know what Lincoln's formation is and what they're about. Just
you say about the big turnover in the both squads, but Blackpool particularly as well.
Absolutely, from when we came last year.
Headed away by the Blackpool defender. Jones comes across, tries to win it. It's cleared into the Lincoln half. Monsmer, Aoma, almost fooled himself, but recovers and plays it back to the goalkeeper. And his pinkish sort of top looks almost purpley in the rain here.
It's looking like a 4-3-3 for Blackpool as well.
Johnson has it. Interesting talking to him in the week. He'll be away on international duty. Could be playing at Wembley this time next week, Tomo, with Wales. It'll be a amazing moment for him as the ball's into the edge of the air. Rowan looking to cross it right across the 6-yard box. Oh, and it comes back for Johnson. He swung his boot at it, couldn't make the right contact. It breaks back for Ioma. Now Bridcut, now Ioma, the right back in towards Johnson, and they could have keeping hold of possession and looking to pass their way through, and they've got it to Jones. Jones holds on to it, looking for support now right down near the corner flag. Gets the right foot across. It's a decent one, and it's just about cleared away by the Blackpool defence back towards the halfway line. But City have already asked questions of this Blackpool defence a couple of times in the space of a minute.
Already under pressure, Blackpool. Good play from Lincoln, using the width of the pitch. Rowan getting forward again, the left back for Lincoln, and a great chance for the player from Tottenham, and really made a poor contact, to be honest, on the volley. But enterprising from Lincoln, and good signs in the first couple of minutes.
Yeah, Lincoln looking the sharper at the moment. Team that have had a very good start to the season, as you all know. It's with Grant, and he played a beautiful ball straight to a Blackpool player. It looked like it was going to be better than that, but the Blackpool players picked it off, and they now look to push forward in the Tangerines. Let's see what sort of football they'll play. You expect with the sort of the background of the manager, they'll look to pass it forward, but will they be as quick to get it forward in the end as Charlton? Well, there's an answer. They played it straight over the top, headed away by Monsmer. Bridcut tidies up, gets it to Jackson. Jackson wide to the left to Rowan. And Rowan, the young Irishman, just spins and plays it back to Jackson. And now with Montsma, four goals to his name this season. Three in the cup, one in the league. And he plays it out towards the left-hand side. Kept in play by Rowan. And he chips it forward. That's got a bit too much on it. That's going to roll through towards the Blackpool keeper.
Well, Blackpool at the moment, through Lincoln's excellent pressure, are struggling to get out of their own half. And really, the only ball they've had to get out of their own half is the long sort of 50, 60-yard ball down the middle of Lincoln, which is bread and butter for the two centre-backs of Lincoln.
Long ball into the Lincoln half. Jackson tracks the run, looking to see that out of play. Blackpool just about keeping in play, right down by the corner flag. Looking to get the cross into the Imps area. It's cut out. They could have to be careful, but they're passing it around. And it's with Bridcutt. And Bridcutt with two Blackpool players around him and manages to get it forward. And Lincoln now with Hopper, trying to show his strength and shows it a little bit too much for the liking of the manager. And he just bundles into the back of the defender. But City, moving the ball quickly, asking questions of Blackpool.
Well, it's good, Michael, from Lincoln City's point of view, is how well they've settled. Really, sometimes you're saying when the away team comes, you're saying to the home manager, listen, they could still be on the bus, get after them, first 10 minutes, put them under pressure, turn them round. But Lincoln have really settled into the game and dominated it possession-wise.
Good block from Johnson. Blackpool having to go back defensively. Now cleared long downfield into the Lincoln half, and City pretty quickly tidy things up. And at the moment, you'd have to say the two teams are looking like the way they started, really, the campaign. Lincoln looking the more confident, but things can change, as we all know, very quickly. It's with Bridcutt, and he just gets pulled back. Referee's going to give a free kick, and I think Bridcutt made just about enough of it to make sure he got that free kick.
Yeah, for me, Lincoln looking the more organised team and the more disciplined team, as though they've got a formation, they know what they're trying to achieve and knowing what they're trying to do. We're Blackpool. Players are sort of all over the pitch at the moment.
Hey, well, Montsma under pressure, plays it all the way back to his goalkeeper. City playing it around quite confidently at the back, very much the mark of the manager. And now out wide, Jones keeps it in play. Back to Montsma on the edge of the area. Looks up, the game's very much in front of him. Aoma's had to come central, but he gets barged into, but holds on to possession. And Palmer's clearance is not a good one. Picked off by Blackpool, but now come forward the tangerine shirts. Out on the right-hand side, chipped inside the area, headed away by a City defender. Rowan looking to make sure it doesn't go out of play, does that. And City tidy things up and clear long. Hopper trying to get on the end of it, can't do so. Blackpool have it, just on the corner of the penalty, looking to cross it into the area, takes a deflection and goes out for a throw.
Yeah, Blackpool's first foray into Lincoln's 18-yard box, and really it was Palmer, the Lincoln goalkeeper, obviously like most teams what you see nowadays, trying to play it out from the back and chip it out to the left back or the left winger for Lincoln, and he got cut out and put Blackpool on the attack. But nowadays that's what teams try and do with their goalkeepers, not down the middle, but give it to the wide players.
As you can probably hear on the microphone, the wind picking up here on the coast, on the Fylde coast. Another throw for Blackpool. We're back here in a fortnight. Tomo liked it so much he asked for another trip.
Yeah.
So we're with the Imps against Fleetwood in a fortnight.
Yeah, I mean, it's a testimony to the pitches nowadays, Michael, isn't it? They just don't like it's been affected at all.
They can try to win it back. Blackpool have it on the edge of the area. Now getting out towards the left-hand side, looking for a chance to get the ball into the area. And that is well dealt with by Montsma. Got his body in the way and he goes out of play for a throw.
Yeah, just starting to settle into the game now, Blackpool. Just starting to show a bit more composure on the ball.
Back towards the halfway line. It's with the centre-half, Husband, and forward now onto the right-hand side. City with plenty of players back, forcing their way forward. Blackpool, Lincoln trying to just block out the space. Sounds echoing around this Bloomfield Road Stadium. Ball inside the area. It's a header from Montsma, and that's just going to take it away and out of the penalty area. It's not going to go for a corner. And the Blackpool player dived there. The referee saw that. And he's allowed Blackpool to continue play. And they have it. And they're going backwards. Be interesting to see if the referee has a conversation with the player once there's a break in play. There's no way the Blackpool players appealed for anything. Blackpool now down by the byline, the over, good challenge, forces the player to go back towards the edge of the area. Jones tries to clear it, Blackpool player goes down again, Iomi gets a challenge in, and that is going to roll out for a throw.
Yeah,
now, what, the referee is going to go back? No, he's just going to have a word, a quiet word with the player who went down. That's a good bit of refereeing for me.
Well, I don't know about you, Michael, I thought there were a couple of continuous decisions there, because the left back of Blackpool saying, don't you think that would have studs up? And I thought it was certainly a free kick on the second occasion.
Throw's already taken. Blackpool trying to find a way through. Lincoln, plenty of bodies in the way. Now it's a right-footed ball spinning to the edge of the D, headed away by Sean Rowan. It's now out with George Grant, and the referee is going to go back for the challenge on a Lincoln player on the edge of the D. I think that's McGrandles, and it's going to be a free kick. We heard from McGrandles in the build-up to the game, Tom. He's one of those unsung types of players, isn't he?
Yeah, we spoke about him the other day, didn't we? Spoke to Rob Makepeace about him, that he just goes about his work, doesn't he? He's more of the fetcher and the carrier, winning the ball, and then if you like, giving it to players that can play, and then really he's the one that breaks play up.
Irma chips it forward, Johnson tracing after it. He's probably got too much on him, but he forces the defender to turn and clear. It's a good play from him. Monsterman with the header forward. It's cleared back into the Lincoln half. Jackson gets his head to the ball. McGrandles hooks it downfield, and Johnson knew he was offside, and it rolls through to the goalkeeper.
Yeah, as I said, they've just eased their way into the game now, Blackpool. Lincoln dominated the first sort of, if you like, 5 or 6 minutes. Then slowly Blackpool have come to terms with the game.
Back to the goalkeeper, a lovely lime green today. Referees in fluorescent yellow. And getting it forward, Blackpool down the right-hand side. And the ball's out of play off a City player.
They're passing the ball better now, Blackpool, and Michael. In the first 5 or 6 minutes, everything was being bashed long, wasn't it, from back to front. Now they're starting to play through the midfield and get a bit more width on the pitch.
Just the one win to their name out of 7 games so far this season. City trying to keep their shape. Only Hopper not defending at the moment. We'll give you that news about the international call-ups and the effect on Lincoln in a moment. There's been a few people asking. Long range! Shot! Oh, is that a save or is that the post?
I think that's hit the post, Michael. I'd have to have a look again. It happened quickly, didn't it? It was a good ball up to the front man, Yates, who had chested it down for one of his teammates to strike it from 20 yards. And it looked like it struck the post, didn't it?
Yeah, it was a shot from just on the D. The fact that it's been given as a goal kick would suggest that the goalkeeper got nothing on it, but it was a shot just down on the edge of the D, and it clattered against the post, Tom. I'm just looking back at the replay there. So a really good opportunity for Blackpool. And as we've seen in recent games, City have seen that sort of come up against them. Teams not taking their chances, and Lincoln being more ruthless. Blackpool, though, pushing forward now as the wind seems to pick up a little bit more. Hamilton, the former Mansell man, charges down. Ball inside the area, right across the six-yard box. City trying to keep it to a clean sheet, and they're going to pick up a goal kick. And, Tommy, you were watching the warm-up when we were talking about all sorts of things in the first hour of the programme, and George Grant really caught your eye.
Yeah, I keep saying his technical ability is very good, and it's beyond this level, to be honest. But it looks to me like he's trimmer this season, and like I say, his work rate's gone up, and he's doing a lot more work without the ball as well as with the ball.
Lincoln City, remember, 100% record in the league.
Showed a bit of pace, Blackpool, down that right-hand side there, yeah. Michael, didn't
he? Hamilton was always a decent player, wasn't he?
Well, he was talked about a long time ago going higher up, but he sort of
His career is stagnated. Back briefly for Lincoln, slides in, gets the challenge, Hopper, good ball to Grant. Grant chips it forward, the running behind from Johnson, he's going to try and get his way in there, and he nearly nicked it off the foot of the defender, but City have it back with Grant, deep inside Blackpool territory. Now Bridcut hasn't got many options, but Ioma manages briefly to hold on to it, and now it's going to be Blackpool coming away until Bridcut slides in and wins his challenge. He goes out for a throw, still 0-0 after 13 minutes here on BBC Radio Lincolnshire.
Yeah, you can see Bridcut's getting into the games now, can't hit the pace of the game. Obviously injured at the start of the season, takes a little while to adapt to the pace of the game, but certainly a mobile midfield player who dictates things in the midfield.
Ball chip downfield, cleared away. Blackpool have it, looking for the long range shot. It hits the City defender, cleared away by another Monsma, high and out of play. Remind you, if you want commentary of Boston United, that's online. Have a look on our social media feeds, and you can find the link there to listen to Rob Makepeace bringing you commentary of Boston's first game of the season.
The key also, Michael, in these conditions is to follow the ball in at both ends. It's been constant rain, hasn't it? And the pitch to me looks lovely and greasy. Great pitch to play on, but need to follow it in at both ends.
Blackpool moving it around. I should say any goals in the Boston game, we'll bring them to you in this commentary as well. Bridcut playing it forward, looking for the run of Hopper. Keeper's come a long way, and he does well in the end, but I thought a manager, heart-in-mouth moment when he comes out towards Hopper. Maybe not quite as close as from our angle it looked.
Well, it's a ball that he had to win, didn't he? And he made a decision, and he read it quite well, actually, because obviously with the turf and the rain at the moment, the ball's going to skid through. But like most goalkeepers nowadays, they act as sweepers.
Blackpool moving it around just inside their own half. They're back for largely inside their own half, apart from Mitchell, who picks it up, pushing forward. Blackpool taking their time. They haven't looked shy of the quick ball forward as well. Hamilton, the ball breaks from, gets past Rowan. Rowan chasing back. Hamilton looking for the cross inside the area. Well dealt with by Jackson and cleared further away by George Grant. But he really looks the danger man for Blackpool this afternoon.
Certainly got the pace, hasn't he? And operating down that right-hand side, it will be a good test for the young lad Rowan this afternoon from Lincoln.
Ball chipped into the Lincoln City area and rather easily gathered in by Palmer.
Yeah, Blackpool just starting to look a bit threatening, and as I said, most of their play is coming down that right-hand side.
City not in any rush. Palmer still holding on to it. He is going to clear long in the end. Blackpool had closed off all the short angles, so Palmer's clearance spirals over the halfway line. Jones looking to get under it, but it's won by Blackpool, and they're just dominating a little bit more at the moment. City started the better, but now Blackpool are on the edge of the area, into the penalty area. Ioma looks to block the cross, and the shot is over the top. Poor effort really from Yates. He spooned it over the top. It's got to hit the target. Remains 0-0.
Great chance for Blackpool, and this time behind down the left hand side, isn't it? And Ocean's a space in Lincoln's right back position, and as the Blackpool player squared it back, the number 9 Yates for Blackpool should have done far better, didn't he? Poor contact with his left foot. Great chance.
Bridcut slides in. Oh, that's not a good ball, and Blackpool could be in here. Bridcut could have got Lincoln into some brother. Shot's driven in, and that's all come. The goal from the mistake from Liam Bridcut. Lincoln, though, do like to play the ball out from the back, and sometimes you can end up shooting yourself in the foot, and Blackpool have taken a 1-0 lead here, Tomo.
Well, my take on that is, Michael, when Blackpool have just had a great scoring opportunity, you think, hang on, you know, we don't want to give them another chance like that, let's get the ball forward into their half. And Bridcut, like most teams and certainly Lincoln, he went and got it off the keeper in his own 18 yard box, and then made a critical mistake giving the ball away, and it's resulted in a goal for Blackpool.
Hamilton's third of the season, former Mansfield man.
It's been coming, Michael, hasn't it? It's been threatening from Blackpool. They've really looked lively in this last 7 or 8 minutes. They've moved the ball quicker, they've got the ball wide, they've got into good areas, and they've got crosses into Lincoln's box.
Well, it's going to be a different sort of an afternoon for Lincoln. They haven't for my reckoning, had to come from behind them. They don't remember it. They've always either been level or had the lead in their league games. They came from behind in against Scunthorpe, didn't they, in the EFL Trophy. You can see the cameraman's been cleaning the lens of his camera just above us. The rain's coming down so much. It's with Blackpool. They have the 1-0 lead. They have, I would presume, ground staff dotted around the ground and club staff watching. The City will clear with Aoba, a high clearance, cleared away by Blackpool's defender. City being asked more questions now. It's through to Hamilton. He virtually controls it. He's got Jackson with him. Jackson gets a foot in to break up the play, but Hamilton holds on to it on the corner of the penalty area, pulls it back. Blackpool looking for a shot from the edge of the area, can't find the space. Move it to the left-hand side. Poor ball is well picked up, though, inside the area. Cleared away by Monster at the cost of a corner.
Hamilton's becoming a real threat for Blackpool, isn't he?
Looks lively, doesn't he?
He's come alive since the goal, being a thorn in Lincoln's side in the last 10 or 12 minutes, and really making things happen for Blackpool.
It's going to be a corner for Blackpool from the attacking left. Number six is taking it. Robson. In towards the 6-yard box, headed away by a defender, and City should bring this one away. And Johnson sprinting forward, he's got Blackpool players flying back. Johnson still going forward, looks to take on the defender, showed him a bit too much of the ball. Back to the goalkeeper it goes, who didn't think it would run the ball quite there, but he clears long. And City have the ball back briefly, and now Blackpool have it, but they're going backwards, and that is a foul from, I think, it's Liam Bridcutt, and it's going to be a free kick.
The problem there, Michael, was the lad from Forest on loan to Lincoln Johnson, so he showed so much pace that no one could keep up with him, and he was left just to take one-on-one, but good defending from the Blackpool defender. But certainly got some pace about him, the young lad.
Certainly has. City 1-0 down, 20 minutes gone. Hamilton's third of the season. Aoba heads clear. No, he heads back behind. I thought he was going to head clear, but he headed out of play, and City just a little bit hesitant in defence.
Well, the thing about that, Michael, is obviously the young players played really well for Lincoln, but if you're going to get that back, especially on the surface today, it's really got to be directed into the keeper, and when it skids off the surface, it's a difficult skill.
Corner from the attacking left. Number six, Robson, who takes it into the area. That's good goalkeeping from Palmer. Good pair of hands from him. He's made himself plenty of space. Checks that there's no Blackpool players around him. Bowls it out to Rowan. He gets it forward, and City are flying forward now down the left-hand side. George Grant, haven't seen a huge amount of him so far this afternoon. And he picks up a free kick right in front of the technical areas. And it's going to be a free kick for the Imps.
The difference for me, Michael, is always, since Blackpool have scored the goal, they've upped their work rate off the ball. I thought they were very lackadaisical trying to win the ball back in the first 6 or 7 minutes, but since they've scored, they've worked a lot harder when Lincoln have got possession.
Monsmer, nice play out towards the left. City moving forward, cross into the finish. Oh, that was nearly through the hopper. The vital stop from the defender. Hopper was ready to unleash a ball into the back of the net, and it didn't quite find him, and it's cleared to the halfway line, and it remains 1-0 to Blackpool.
Excellent defending from Blackpool. That was a great ball in from the left-hand side of from Lincoln, and the Blackpool defender, if he got that wrong, it was a certain chance for Hopper, but the Blackpool defender did well just to get a clearance.
Yeah, it was a terrific ball into the area. I mean, Hopper literally was ready to pull the trigger, wasn't he? Poor clearance from City's keeper, bounces out, going to be a throw. Rowan sprints back, he's in position, and Blackpool looking to find a way through to double their lead. City win it back with Bridcup, does well, gets it to McGrandles. McGrandles tries to show his strength, does enough to win a throw. couple of steps inside their own half.
Sorry, Michael, I just think that sometimes if the goalkeeper for Lincoln can't get the ball into wide positions, you can't force it and try and make it happen. I mean, Hopper's a big target man up there, and surely you might just have to hit him and go central and play off him.
That's a long ball to the right, and it's one for Johnson to trace after. Can he beat the defender up against Mitchell? Johnson, oh, terrific pace,
penalty.
And the penalty comes. That was all because of Johnson's terrific pace, Tomo. He stood up the defender, Mitchell, and then he went again, and the leg went out, and that was an easy decision for the referee. You could see in the defender's body language straight away it was a penalty.
Well, it was his quick feet that did it more than anything, Michael Johnson. I mean, he got the pace when he got in behind. But
watching the replay here, Tomo.
It was all about his quick feet. If you watch his feet, Michael, in the box, he moves the ball and...
No doubt.
Really makes, he makes the Blackpool defender commit himself in the 18-yard box.
Third Saturday running, George Grant's got a penalty. Scored one last week, had one saved, then scored in controversial style last week. The week before, scored at MK Dons. What's it going to be today? Is George Grant going to level it here at Bloomfield Road? Wipes all the water off his face. Plenty of rain still falling here. And he's up against Maxwell, looking to try and level things for Lincoln City here at Blackpool. Up steps George Grant, and he's got it in. 1-1 Lincoln City. I paused for a second because I think the keeper got pretty close to it. It was slightly obscured to me, but I thought he may just have got a fingertip to it, but it was, in the end, a very good penalty.
Yeah, I think the problem for the Blackpool keeper, Laurie went the right way, and it looked like he might have got to it. It was the pace of the ball. It was great pace on the ball. Obviously, with his technical ability and strikes, a good ball, Grant.
Well, Michael Appleton really liked the fact that Lincoln have come back. Yeah, he's just the pace beat him in the end, wasn't it? The keeper went the right way watching that replay, Tomo. Just the pace was too much. But a good response from City.
Absolutely, it's good that, I mean, with Blackpool's pressure, after this, when they scored the first goal, they were pushing for a second. Obviously, the last thing you want to do is go two down. And the fact that Lincoln have equalised now, it just put Blackpool on the back foot.
I thought we saw from Johnson there as well, Tommy, it's not just about having pace, it's about when you use it. You know, just little injections, which is what he did there, wasn't it? Just a couple of injections of pace.
Well, the other thing is, well, the other players know as well, whether it's Johnson or Harry Anderson out there, they know that when they do put that ball in behind, if it's got the right weight on it, the pace that they've got, they can get into those positions and really use the pace.
Chip down the line. It looks like it should go out of play. It does. He can slide the Blackpool half.
It was his feet, Michael Johnson. He moved his feet really quick, and the Blackpool defender had got it in. No arguments, penalty.
Yeah, very good for Lincoln City. 1-1 the scoreline. Been an interesting game so far here on BBC Radio Lincolnshire. Talk about the games with goals in League One in a moment. We get a break in play, but Blackpool looking to get the ball out of their own half. City got plenty of players pressing the space. One of them, Ayoma, chips it down the channel, the right channel. The defender's going to play it back to his goalkeeper. And he's got plenty of time to sort himself out, roll the ball towards the penalty spot, and then pause. So we can tell you that Wimbledon 1-0 up at home to Accrington, although they're actually playing at QPR at the moment, I think, for a few more weeks, as City tidy things up and clear and pick up a throw. Burton winning 2-1 against Portsmouth. Big pressure, I think, on the Portsmouth manager. Hull 1 up at Argyle. Ipswich 1-0 up at the MK Dons. Swindon leading at Peterborough by a goal to nil. Rochdale 1-0 up at home to Fleetwood. And Shrewsbury lead Gillingham by a goal to nil.
I mean, Peter, you would imagine one of the favourites for this season, really not started well at all.
No. Yes, you can have sticky starts when you've got so many places up for grabs. Ayoma overplaying a bit, but gets away with it. Back to his goalkeeper. But another testing afternoon so far for City's defenders. Lincoln concede possession. Forward come the tangerine shirts of Blackpool to the edge of the City penalty area. Chipped left footed inside the area. Time for Yates to bring the ball down. City can't win it back. Yates, good strength from him, holds on to it. Back into midfield, chipped into the box again. Lincoln with a chance with Jackson to clear. Goes high into the dark sky. Comes down on the boot of one of the Blackpool players. And City have got all bar Hopper, and even he's virtually defending now as well, just in front of their penalty area, just making it difficult for Blackpool, closing down the space. Ball pushed in, Jones gets a shove, referee doesn't think so. Johnson with another chance to charge forward, he's eased off the ball, referee not interested. Well, Tommy, what do we think of that?
I think there's two free kicks. I thought it was first one to Lincoln, and then Johnson undoubtedly fouled in front of us. He was just pushed off the ball.
It wasn't like the referee was miles away either. Now CJ Hamilton shows his pace, dives.
Oh, referee.
And the referee and the assistant are not interested. We'll get the replay in a second, Tommy. What was your gut feeling?
Well, from a million miles away, it was. I just thought Rowan maybe pushed him in the back, because he's certainly got the beating of him pace-wise, hasn't he?
I wonder if he hadn't not given Hamilton Johnson's foul, do you know what I mean? What might have been in the referee's mind? Long throw into the Lincoln penalty area, headed away. Johnson trying to clear it, and he's caught the Blackpool player right on the edge of the area. A really, really frenetic stuff.
Yeah, it's poor defending from Lincoln, really. They're just not reacting to the second balls, and it's got to be said, Michael, that Rowan, as much potential as he's got, he's having a bit of a torrid time from Hamilton down that right-hand side.
Yeah, he's really showing his pace this afternoon. No Melbourne in the matchday squad today.
I mean, there's only one way this free kick. It's got to be driven. There's no way it can go over the top. There's not enough room to get it up and over the wall.
Do you have every player in the wall? They're looking like they're doing it.
Yeah, I'm not quite happy.
It looks like two walls almost.
It seems to be a gap to me.
And it's driven straight to the Lincoln player, and it comes out of the area, and that felt like a bit of a waste to me. Blackpool on the edge of the penalty box, looking for a way through. Long range shot is well over the top. Remains 1-1.
Corner? I'm not quite sure.
Didn't touch a Lincoln player, did it?
It seems to be just high, wide and handsome to me.
He's had a little mare for a few minutes.
I can't recollect Lincoln having any 7-foot players, can you?
No. Well, I didn't think it did. But there we go.
Good to see from Lincoln, Michael, the wall standing resolute and taking it.
Robson. Maybe it didn't. Looking back at the replay, it might just have caused a Lincoln player. Ball into the box back post, and it's headed wide. That's a goal kick. It looked like it might have just taken a slight deflection, Tommy, to be fair.
Okay, ref, well played. That was a clear header at the far post for a Blackpool player, and it was a biscuit tin for a head, wasn't it?
30 minutes gone in the game. 1-1 scoreline. City working their way forward. Rowan. Ball is bobbling away from him, and in the end he can't control it. Goes out of play. Blackpool have it just inside the Lincoln half. They go back into their own. They go backwards to go forward. City pressing the space in the form of McGrandles and Grant. Score of Lincoln's equaliser from the penalty spot. Penalty in the last three Saturday games. Two scored, one scored after... Well, if you believe the Charlton people, Harry Anderson put it back in. If you believe the opposite view, it came off a Charlton defender. Or if you're Tomo, you think both did it.
It's been a pretty even game, hasn't it? I think possession would just slightly edge towards Blackpool, but it's not the possession, it's what you do with the possession, what you do with the ball. And as I said, the first 10 minutes where Blackpool really looked a bit bedraggled to me, they've settled down as the home team and really... Use the pace well in the flanks.
That was handball. Now the referee has given the free kick the other way. What have you made of Johnson so far, Tom? I've seen a bit more of him now. We only saw, what, 10 minutes or so, didn't we? But what is penalty? And he's very graceful in his running. He's and very quick.
Yeah, he's certainly got pace to burn, hasn't he? And obviously, you know, when you get a player like that, he's in the Welsh squad, he's going to have ability on the ball, which he showed in winning the penalty. Just can't get the ball out.
High
to
ball
him.
Into the Lincoln penalty. The keeper pauses, headed across 6-yard box, and Jackson looks to see that out of play. had a really nervous moment. It was a smart header from a Blackpool point of view. It needed somebody to run in, but it was a smart header, don't you think?
Yeah, too much room at the far post for the Blackpool player. I just wonder where TJ was. Lincoln's right back when that ball came in. He should be tucked in round his centre back defending that far post.
Clearance for Palmer. The scoreboard behind him to his left and up at the top of the stand reads Lincoln 1-1 against Blackpool. 32 minutes and 53 seconds gone. Headed back into the Lincoln half and out of play by a Tangerines player. And it's going to be a City throw for Sean Rowan to take. He throws it into the. It goes past George Grant. And Blackpool play all the way back to their goalkeeper. And they had a really bright start in terms of creating problems. And obviously they've had the goal back, but you'd say that Blackpool have had more of the game, probably. But as we've seen, things change often at half-time. Can Blackpool make the most of their, I wouldn't say dominance, but their opportunities? Moving it around, City blocking off the space. Out towards the left now. City trying to make it difficult, but the run into the area comes. Jones tries to ease the player away, and Blackpool nearly found a way through, sliding it into the box, but Palmer comes out and gathers it in.
Yeah, sometimes a Blackpool player didn't pull the trigger there on the edge of Lincoln's 18-yard box, trying to be too clever for me, and it was too tight to place a pass into Lincoln's 18-yard box. Certainly Blackpool's approach play has been very good in this first half once they've settled into the game.
He's Steve Thompson, I'm Michael Horton, this is BBC Radio Lincolnshire. And City are defending, Aoma clears, and then clever little ball from Johnson. Aoma tries to be too clever himself there and concedes possession. And Blackpool have it centrally, driving forward with Robson out towards the right, towards the full-back Turton. City with plenty of players back defending. In fact, only Hopper really not involved in this defensively. Back towards the halfway line. City just making their limiting the space for Blackpool, but Blackpool hold on to it. Now they're coming out towards the left-hand side. Mitchell, the left-back, is there for the ball, but the centre-half seeing a lot of it. That's out towards the right. Hamilton's going to get into people. Rowan does well that time. He read it quicker and he's now striding forward. His ball, though, is not a great one. It was too far in front, but credit to Sean there because he read the ball much quicker than Hamilton that time. Hamilton now making the run inside of him, sprinting into the area. But Lincoln have Palmer, who's very alive to that.
Yeah, did well, the young fullback there, in reading it, but then just got carried away, didn't he? And body was going too quick for his head.
Not a problem I ever have. It's Rowan getting it forward. Oh, spooned off the boot of the Blackpool defender and out of play for a throw for City inside the Blackpool half. Can they build a little bit of pressure in the remaining 10 minutes or so and try and find a goal to go in front in this game? 1-1 the scoreline. It's with Hopper. Hopper, first time ball inside there, nobody's there. Should be an easy one for Blackpool to clear. City trying to close down the space, but calm piece of football from the Blackpool man, and they're over the halfway line. McGrandall's tracking back to try and close down the space, but Blackpool pushing forward with Anderson. And now Turton, and then it's Hamilton. And out on the right with Blackpool once again. Into feet. But Lincoln win it back. Lovely ball from Grant into Jones. Jones back to Grant, who's running down the left-hand side. Two players inside him. Can he find the right balls? Joined by a couple more. He just dwelt on it a little bit too much. Tried to get away from the defender. And it just breaks down for Lincoln City. And they're short-manned at the back now. If Blackpool can move this quick enough. Ball played out towards the left-hand side. And the man who conceded the penalty pretty quickly pokes it out towards Lubala on the corner of the penalty area. Looking for a chance for a shot. Terrific that from young Johnson. Blocking off the shot. Getting back in the right position and blocking off the shot. And now a ball into the area. And it's stabbed away by Monsma, and now Jones chips it forward. Johnson chasing after it. Two Blackpool players around him. and he does enough to win a throw. But he did well there defensively. Good to see him get back.
Terrific to see one of your forward players defending like a defender. I mean, that was a defensive block and a very important block. So good play from the young player.
Aoma. He's going to get the ball back from McGrandles and play it all the way back to Monsmer. City, as ever, look confident in possession. There was an error in that led to the first goal.
He just loves hitting that long diagonal, doesn't it, Monsmer?
The right to left.
It just gets cut out too often. He can't force it.
Ball forward from Blackpool. Lincoln equalising through a George Graham penalty after Johnson was tripped by the full-back, the left-back. No real doubt about it, no real controversy around it this week. Blackpool playing forward, but it's one back, this time by Bridcut. Bridcut pushing forward. He's got two players around him, picks up the free kick. And that was smart play for me from Bridcut that time. He had two players around him. He was going to struggle to get the ball away. And in the end, he's given George Grant a pop at goal with the free kick.
Yeah, you thought he'd dwell on the ball, Bridcut, but he had to because there was no one in around him. So he had to buy some time for his team and won the free kick. Yeah, it's got to be a strike, surely.
Possibly Jones, because Jones, as we've seen, what away at Bradford in open play, can hit it. Yeah, but you'd think it's George Grant, really.
You think it's, as you said, Grant or Jones.
It's not in a bad position, really. The wall, sometimes you can be a bit too close, can't you? The wall's going to have to be pretty much on the edge of the penalty area. It looks like the referee is striding out towards there. In fact, he's let them come forward half a pace outside of the area, so they're actually in the D. And Lincoln City with a free kick to try and take the lead here at Bloomfield Road.
It's not the best wall I've seen either.
It looks like it's going to be Jones. George Grant's walked away. Jones is still there.
That is a poor wall, defensive wall.
What can Lincoln do here? Can Jones find a second goal of the season for him, a first in the league? Blast the referee's whistle, up steps Jones, and he hits the wall. He appeals for a handball, chases after the ball and retrieves it himself, and looks to get it forward again. Terrific run from Hopper inside the penalty area to the corner flag, and it goes out of play off a Blackpool player for a throw. Wall held, Tomo.
Yeah, he stood firm. They actually got together as the ball was struck. There were too many gaps to start with, but someone must have pulled the wall together. But good bit of pressure from Lincoln, this.
Jackson to Monsmer. Monsmer inside the centre circle, into McGrandles. Back to Jackson, furthest player back. Now he comes forward and plays it straight through the middle. Hopper's held off, but Jones comes flying through. And now it's Johnson! Oh, is that tipped over? No, it's over directly from Johnson. What a great move from Lincoln, though. We were right down the line of it.
I thought it was destined for certainly either bottom right-hand corner, but he got too good a contact on it, I think, Johnson, didn't he? And I don't know what you think, Michael. It looked like the goalkeeper first when all I first saw it. Got a touch, but maybe not. But once again, Johnson causing trouble there on this right-hand side.
It looks like the recruitment team, including the manager, have got the job right, haven't they, in bringing Johnson to the club? They were long-term interest in him, but they were keeping their patience until he became available.
Keeping their powder dry.
Yeah. They said there was one player they wanted, and they knew exactly who he was, and if they could get him, they would. If they weren't going to get him, they would not worry about it. Which seems refreshing sort of attitude compared to some clubs who think, oh, I've got a lot of money, I better go and spend it on somebody.
Yeah, it's becoming a bit of a feeder club for Lincoln, Nottingham Forest, isn't it? But if it's there, use it. I mean, the club's only down the road. Got to use it.
Yeah, you'd say George Grant's been a great signing, and obviously Tyler last season. I think I inadvertently moved Paul Green from Villa to Forest when he came to the club, and he was a Villa player. But John Finnegan, another one. But many years ago he is. I mean, you're going back a long time, Tomo.
Yeah, when I was managing, I was going to watch Forest Reserves. When they had Big Paul Hart doing that academy, and there was, you know, Jermaine Jenner's coming through and Dawson coming through. Andy Reid, they're like a conveyor belt of young
very
players.
They're technically good, aren't they?
Yeah, but there's a conveyor belt of young players coming through at Forest.
3 minutes to half-time. 1-1 the scoreline. Both sides have had opportunities to extend their score, not been able to take them just yet.
I think we've gone into Arctic conditions, Michael.
Oh, I need gloves, I need a second layer. I bought a summer jacket, that was stupid, wasn't it? Was it Radio Cumbria who have a radiator at Brunton Park? Oh, I could do without now. Anyway, it's Blackpool pushing forward.
Well, last year when we were here, the supporters were all to our left, weren't they?
It does help.
A windbreak, wasn't it?
Yeah. And I was hoping you would be, but you're not.
How can I do so much, Michael?
Johnson has it back, loses possession. Ball with Blackpool attacking down the left-hand side. So you're going to have to be careful here. Don't want to concede before half-time. Poor play from the Blackpool fullback. Lincoln have it back. Jones chips it forward. Hopper's pushed over. And that is an easy decision. I said to the manager last week, you know, Hopper, six fouls. He picks up plenty of them. He's very skilled at it. And the manager replied, but they're all fouls, though, Michael. I was like, yeah, he's just very good at it. And it also breaks up the play when Lincoln need it.
But that's all you want him to do. Anything involved around the halfway line and sort of 10 yards into the opponent's half, just hold the ball up.
Defender clears with Hopper lurking. Back towards the halfway line. Lincoln trying to win it back in midfield. Sliding challenge from McGrandles. And tidy it up and back with the Dutchman Monsma. Jackson. It's going to be cleared long to the halfway line. Jones goes up, tries to flick it on. And then it's over the top. Hopper is offside, but it's not him who's going to get the ball. Jones sprints after it, really energetic from him. Aoma back to Jones, out on the right-hand side. Crosses it, and it's going to go out for a throw. Well charged down by the Blackpool players. Less than a minute to go, plus stoppage time.
Yeah, Hopper took a great position at the far post as well, but just couldn't move it quick enough, Lincoln, to get it to the far post. But Hopper, like most centre-forwards, just get to the far post and look for the cross coming in.
Lincoln City with Aoma. Now Johnson back to Aoma. City with players around. Johnson on the corner of the area, goes past one, into the area, pulls it across, hits the defender, wins a corner. Terrific stuff.
Oh, it's fast feet again, Michael. Oh. He moves the
ball. I can't talk that fast now.
he moves the ball from right to left very quick, doesn't he?
And you can see they're worried about putting a challenge in them as well, aren't they? Back towards Grant. Grant drives it right across to the back post, headed back into the area. And in comes Grant, he heads it down. Oh, and it's going to be cleared away. City very close to getting that chance. We've got a minute of stoppage time to play. Well charged down by Bridcutt. But Blackpool breaking forward, looking for a goal in the last minute of the first half. But not like that, they're not going to. It goes out of play, but both sides really offering around the edge of the air, and I think there's more goals to come in the second half, Tomo.
Absolutely. I mean, for me, it's been an entertaining first 45 minutes. Both teams trying to play. Obviously, Bridcutt getting caught out for Blackpool's goal, really, and playing in a poor position. And then a penalty won by Johnson with his excellent pace.
Ball over the top, Johnson looks off to me.
Must
in the 80s. And I think that's the half. Fooled me then. I thought it was going to be the half-time whistle.
It was just testing the whistle, wasn't he?
We'll catch up with Boston at half-time in FA Cup action. Grantham as well. Not heard anything of either, so I'm assuming they're goalless in those games at the moment, but we'll find out in a bit. Long clearance into the Lincoln half, and that is half-time, and it feels like a pretty fair scoreline to me, really. Both sides have given their best push forward, and it was Hamilton who opened the scoring. Bridcutt, Lincoln liked to do, playing it around the back, got caught out, and Hamilton got his third goal of the season. But City were not to be outdone. They pushed forward, and the clever feet and the twinkling feet of Johnson gave Lincoln a penalty, and George Grant this week scored straight from the spot. City have had chances since, Blackpool have had chances since, but it remains 1-1.
Yeah, I mean, Blackpool for the home side started poor in the first 10 minutes, and Lincoln really settled to the work, and they looked very dominant and composed, Lincoln, in that first 10 minutes. But then Blackpool edged their way into the game and certainly started using the flanks, with Hamilton certainly down that right-hand side causing lots of trouble. And as they settled into the game, both teams trying to play football, as we said.
Screwfix proudly supports football at home. Score 12 cans of Carabao Green Apple free when you buy any 12-pack of Carabao. Head to carabaoenergy.co.uk/shop and enter the discount code I follow to redeem the offer. Offer valid while stocks last.
Have you ever seen anything like this? Wow!
You're not betting against that. Championship doesn't stop for the last day.
Look at this! That's glorious!
That's the WWE you're saying is a good
fight. Oh, that is naughty.
It's outrageous!
They're getting better and better. It's pretty ominous for everybody else.
Screwfix proudly supports football at home.
Can start? 21. Win
as one. That's sick.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready, yeah. Good evening, everyone.
Have you heard the Duffs?
No.
We just went through this. Hugh Edwards is sitting there waiting for the sound to start. Then he starts, okay? Are you ready? Richard?
Good evening.
No! He doesn't do that, does he? When you hear the Duffs come on, that's when we need the headlines from your house, okay? Are you ready?
Today's headlines in Fishtop. Richard has been tidying in the garage.
Excellent!
William Wright.
Monday from 6 o'clock.
BBC Radio Lincolnshire.
I wish it wasn't.
and glory.
BBC Radio Lincolnshire.
See Radio Lincolnshire if you're indoors. I know you'd love to be with us at the football, but maybe it's the day to be indoors. It's absolutely throwing it down here in Blackpool, and it makes it all the more gloomy with so many empty seats. Right, let's do some updates half-time on our games. Boston United first, and Rob, very much going the Pilgrims' way on their opening day in the FA Cup.
It is in terms of the scoreline, but it could have been very different. Yeah, Boston leading by 3-1 here against AFC Mansfield. 2 goals in 2 minutes, giving Boston a comfortable lead early on. First one was a mix-up between the defender and the goalkeeper for Mansfield, led Terry Hawkridge for a simple tap-in for his first for the club. A minute later, it was a Jordan Thewlis shot parried away into the path of Jordan Burrow. Again, a simple tap-in from a yard out to give Boston a 2-0 lead. You thought they'd go on and secure a comfortable victory this afternoon, but far from it. Instead, 26 minutes in, Linton Carcash with great persistence, former Gainsborough Trinity man, scoring at the Northome, low shot into the bottom corner, and Mansfield could have been level. It was wonderful play from the centre forward, Ross Duggan, who's been causing Boston all sorts of issues. He managed to wriggle himself free to get a shot away, and it rebounded off the post and was just so close to going into the back of the net. Boston, though, restoring their 2-goal advantage just before the break. Corner from Thanoj, header from Shields. Boston 3-1 up as we head into the second 45.
Good stuff. Thank you, Rob. What about Grantham Town in the FA Cup? Graham Cowell.
Well, no goals here at the Mears. The Gingerbreads perhaps just shading the first half, but for that 35 minutes, neither goalkeeper has really been stretched. The Gingerbreads have come closest twice, and the ball's been played into the edge of the six-yard box, and headers from Ramay Campbell and Tom Ward have flown just wide of the target, but Sean Rowley not called into action in the Matlock goal. The Gingerbreads dominating, putting crosses into the box, but they've been dealt with fairly comfortably by a Matlock defence, as has happened at the other end on the few occasions when Matlock have got space to put the ball into the centre. Jan Butts having to come and punch one corner clear from inside his six-yard box, but other than that, there's been no alarms for the Gingerbreads goalkeeper. It can only get better after half-time. Grantham Town 0, Matlock Town 0.
And in the other FA Cup tie, I can tell you Stamford are 2-0 up against Royston Town. So it looks like we could have two of our non-league sides through to the next round of the FA Cup. Fingers crossed Grantham can improve their position and join them. Other local scorelines is Lincoln are already out here at Bloomfield Road, and we're the Blackpool players just coming out as well. In the South Eastern Division, Lincoln United won, Stocksbridge Park Steels won. The Spalding match at Market Drayton postponed. In the UCL, Anstey Nomads 2, Sleaford 0. Boston Town 1-0 up at Wellingborough Town. DP Rangers, we're at this for a half-time score, leading Leicester Nevada 4-3, and Desborough 1-0 up against Holbeach United. Pinchbeck against Corner Mention, I saw that earlier on social media, that game having been postponed. Right, Lincoln City remind you, are 1-1 here against Blackpool. They are Palmer in goal, Ioma Jackson, Monsma and Rowan, the back four, as there is a change for Lincoln. Sean Rowan coming off, and he has been replaced by Teo Eden, who's going to go in at left back. So one change for Lincoln. So we get Tomo's thoughts on that in a second. So it's Ioma, Jackson, Monsma and Eden, the back four. Jones, Bridker and McGrandles in midfield. Johnson, Hopper and Grant up top on the bench for Lincoln remaining. Ross, Scully, Archibald, Howarth, Elbazidi off an international duty soon, and Anderson. And Eden's going to take a throw. Another player that Tomo very impressed with when he played at left back last season. Blackpool holding on to it as they try to get it forward, and it comes through to Jackson, who clears long downfield. Oh, and it's bounced over the defender. It's a chance for Johnson to run in behind. The ball wasn't really kind to him. Johnson plays it inside. Ayo was barged over. Referee not interested. And now Blackpool come flying forward. Lincoln with four defenders back. Three Blackpool players flying forward as well. Ball pulled back. It's beyond Jones. Very central. What are Blackpool going to do? They're going to get out to the danger man. It's a real chance for him now. Hamilton. And then a right-footed lift. Ball inside the area and well dealt with by Palmer. Maxwell in goal, Turton and the number 21 Ekepita, Husband and Mitchell make up the back four, as there is a challenge which I didn't see. Tommy, you're going to have to talk me through it. I can see Johnson on the floor. I didn't see if there was a yellow card, but you'll have to talk me through it. I was looking at,
well, Johnson,
notes.
He's got the ball at feet on the right hand side, and he was just preparing to take the left back on a Blackpool, and the left back on Blackpool just, it was like a kamikaze pilot. He was fired out of a cannon and just fouled Johnson and thought, that's the only way I'm going to stop him.
Hamilton, Yates and Lubala make up the front three. Sims, Gabriel, Williams, Sarkic, Medine, Kemp and Garbutt is the bench for Blackpool. Free kick for Lincoln City. Another bright start from these two teams. It's certainly been an entertaining game. Hopefully you're enjoying it on Radio Lincolnshire and indeed on iFollow around the world. I understand Tomo is sounding a bit like Terminator occasionally on iFollow. Ball into the box and it's a chance for Hopper! Oh, he headed wide and the goal was gaping. Tom, a terrific ball in the box. Should be 2-1, shouldn't it?
Is it down to inferior equipment or...?
No, I think it's down to technology that's making you sound occasionally like the Terminator I've seen on social media. Oh. You'll be back one day.
You're asking me about Rowan. I just think it was a bit of a tough baptism this afternoon for him.
Hamilton's got real pace as well, hasn't he?
I think that Mike Lapton's seen the danger down this left-hand side, and obviously the young fella, he's got bags and bags of potential, but he's up against a very, very good opponent, and he probably feels that Aidan, with his experience, can handle it better.
And that's why you have squads, isn't it, at the end of the day. Sometimes it's not right for one player, and Lincoln could be caught out here. Into the middle comes Hamilton! Oh, and he puts it wide.
Oh, what a chance.
That must have been inches wide. He just settled himself right. He got beyond Jackson, and he looked to put it into the top corner, and it's inches wide.
Yeah, I think the pace off the turf took Jackson out of the game. It skidded past him, didn't it? And that allowed Hamilton just to get in behind him. But Hamilton, the form he's in and the goals he's been scoring, you would expect him to pull that in, but just wide of the post. A let off for Lincoln.
Headed on for City. And Lincoln asking questions, Blackpool asking questions.
Do you think they could have anything to do with the pounding wind, the Terminator?
I think it's to do with broadband speeds. I don't know. Somebody can probably tell me, who's much more technically knowledgeable, but it's nothing to do with your body, Tomo, or the microphone next to it.
It's not my teeth chattering, I can assure you.
If anyone wants to create, if they're bored and wants to create an image of the Terminator with Tomo on it, it'll at least amuse me on the journey home.
No, I'm fine, thank you.
1-1 the score, especially in his sheepskin jacket, which is on today, if you're wondering. Hamilton comes away with the ball down the right-hand side, taking on three Lincoln players, and they're all getting back, getting their challenges in. But, it's well won back by Ed, and that's good play from him. Holds on to it, being pulled. Referee gives the free kick in the end.
Yeah, he's going to rely on Eden's experience here, because once again, in his opening minutes, it's all coming down Lincoln's left-hand side, obviously Blackpool's right-hand side, and it's all due to Hamilton's pace.
Ben says, when the commentary goes a bit robotic on iFollow, we should start calling Michael and Tomo Horty and Tomo Nater. Tomo Nater. Ball over the top. Johnson looking to get hold of it. Just lets it get away from him. Defender comes in the way and puts it out for a corner. He really is giving that fullback a difficult afternoon. The two left backs are having difficult games today, aren't they?
Yeah, and that's where all the problems are coming, aren't they, from both teams. One is Johnson for Lincoln down there, Lincoln's right hand side. And as we've said, Hamilton for Blackpool down there, down Lincoln's left hand side. But it's certainly been a good open attacking game, and you would think, Michael, there would be more goals in it.
More goals in it, yeah. Lincoln take the corner short. McGrandles lifts it into the box, headed away by a defender. Picked up by Grant. Grant slides it for McGrandles, who's inside the area, coming forward, slides it across the six-yard box, cleared away. And it's going to bounce all the way through to Ayoma. Ayoma, and he gets it back on the halfway line. And it's just going backwards for Lincoln at the moment. The furthest man back is the captain, Bridker. And Bricker looks downfield, plays the ball for the run, and the run is from Ayoma, and it's just got a bit too much on it, and it's gathered in by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, both teams are still playing out from the back and still looking to play on the deck and through the midfield.
Somebody's saying we sound like Daleks when the sound goes wrong as well. It's out of play for a corner.
Modern technology.
It's supposed to make life better, isn't it? Thanks to Johnny for that one.
Well, it's certainly the coldest I've been this season, Michael. Oh, I don't know about you.
A country mile.
It's never stopped, isn't it? It's just been persistent rain, hasn't it? From early morning.
It is going to be a corner then for Blackpool from the attacking right. It's going to be one that will be right-footed, so it should go away from goal a bit. Into the air it goes, near post as a Blackpool player over, hooked forward and over the top, and it's not a threat to Palmer, and it remains 1-1 here on BBC Radio Leicester. Boston United 3-1 up, Stamford 2-0 up, Grantham 0-0, all in the FA Cup.
It's got to be said, the pitches nowadays are just conducive to better football, aren't they? I mean, they're like snooker tables.
Yep, certainly are. Lincoln have it back. Bridcut slides it forward to Hopper, fouled, and yet again another foul for Hopper. I tell you, I mean, he had six last week against Charlton, I think, and he's already had at least three. But like you said, that's where you want it, isn't it?
Well, I suppose if I was the away manager, I'd be screaming that he goes down too easy. But I mean, that's the game, isn't it? I mean, as I keep saying, that's his job, to hold the ball up and enable his teammates to play off him. And he does it well.
Oh, McGrandles makes himself some space. Have to be careful here, but he slides it to his captain, Bridcut, who chips it forward, looking for Jones to run after it, but it's got a bit too much on it, and it bounces through to the goalkeeper.
Good engines, Jones, Michael, getting forward. Makes some good runs from the midfield.
He's certainly a better player than when we talked to our colleagues on the opening day and we asked them about him. They weren't that full of praise for him, were they?
No, maybe a bit of sour grapes, the fact that he'd left, but he's certainly coming into the games for Lincoln.
Yates, lovely little turn, and he shoots just wide. That was a fantastic piece of skill from Yates, made himself the space, and we were right behind it. I think anyone else, I think you had a slightly different angle, so it looked closer to you probably. I was right behind it, probably missed by about half a metre.
Yeah, I was just saying, it's been disappointing, Yates, for Blackpool. He's not held a ball up, and that's his first contribution for me in the game. It was a cute little turn, wasn't it? And went to bend it into the top right-hand corner of his left foot.
Still raining, in case you're wondering. There's no rain shortage here, no water shortage, that's for sure. From Lincoln in action Tuesday night against Mansfield. We'll have commentary on Radio Lincolnshire. Boston also playing Tuesday, opening their league campaign. Commentary online of them. Thrown in to feet. Blackpool pushing forward. Lincoln trying to win the ball back. And Blackpool hold on to it. Get out towards the right hand side. The danger man, Hamilton. Pulled it forward. I'll explain why I laugh in a second, sorry. It's not somebody's tripped over this week. It's cleared by Ed, and in fact it goes out of play, and it's going to be a throw. We'll talk about it in a second, but let's see what Blackpool can do with this attacking throw. Thrown in. It's going to be Hamilton on his left. Drifts the ball in the box. It's in the end an easy one for Palmer, and clearly, as I said, I think, do people have much time on their hands? The answer is yes, as they can listen and create a picture of Tomo as if he's the Terminator. We'll mention that in a set, or the Tominator is probably a better description. Blackpool coming forward, and City defending. Blackpool right around the byline. Hamilton looking for the cross. Ed tries to block it, but Bridcut is there and wins the ball back and very calmly chips it forward, looking for Hopper. And Lincoln are getting a little deep here, Tomo, aren't they? They're getting a bit deeper at the moment, and Blackpool not asked the big question yet of Palmer in this period of play, but City are just getting a bit deep.
Yeah, just inviting the pressure, and as you said, defending deep. And I repeatedly say that the way out of it is that when you get good possession, you push up the pitch, condense the game.
Blackpool player stumbled on the ball but holds on to it. Looking to get it forward. It's well won back by Jackson. The referee didn't like the challenge. Blackpool take the free kick quickly out towards the left-hand side, halfway inside the City half. Pushing towards the edge of the area. Mitchell, the fullback, crosses inside the area. That's a poor cross, really, straight at the chest of Palmer, who gathers it in. And do you like yourself as the Tominator?
No, I preferred it. Chart when I were called Rambo.
Oh, don't you start them. Next it'll be Rambo. And then, I don't know, somebody from the Magic Roundabout. Or
That was a chart. But, it's... you keep thinking his goal's coming, don't you? But it's just when they get in good positions, both teams, it's just the final ball into the box and not making enough of it.
Bridcut, Johnson, back towards Monsmouth. City could do with a little period of possession.
You just look at Blackpool there, Michael. They pushed up.
Yep.
They pushed up, denied.
Lincoln just ran out of ideas and chipped it downfield.
Absolutely, and that's what you have to do, even if you just come 5 yards.
57 minutes gone, 0-0. 1-1 the scoreline. George Grant's reply to Hamilton's goal. And speaking of him, he's charging forward, Hamilton. And Teo Edens is happy to put the ball out of play. Surely the Blackpool manager wants to take Hamilton off. He's creating nothing. he's looked, I think, in terms of opposition, probably the most dangerous player we come up against this season, I think. I'm trying to think. I mean, obviously, Liverpool game aside.
Well, I mean, the most penetrative players on the pitch have been Hamilton for Blackpool and Johnson for Lincoln.
Corner from the attacking right, drifted into the near post, headed away, and it's not quite cleared away. Chance for the shot if he can sort his feet out, but charged down, bounces up inside the area, headed sideways. Very calm from Teo Eden, and then George Grant clears long, and Johnson can't get on the end of it. Blackpool win it back, and they're pushing forward again. Bridcutt slides in with the challenge, ball inside the area, gathered in by Palmer.
Got away with that one, Monson. He went to clear it, missed it completely, but fortunately, Palm, the Lincoln goalkeeper, read it well.
Oh, I think you're all right as the Tominator.
Oh.
I've just seen it. Thank you to Gary.
What I want is a wanted sign and reward. If they put that on Crime Watch, I'd be arrested.
Low ball downfield, Hoffman are going to flick it on for Lincoln. And Johnson can't get on it, and it rolls out of play. It's going to be a throw. Teo Eden takes it into Jones, back to Ioma, and Ioma looking to get it forward. Now it's with Bridcutt, now Johnson. It's all very tight at the moment. There's a foul there, the referee's going to go back for it, and Jones not too happy, gets back up, gestures at the officials.
I don't think that warrants a yellow card, but there's been a lot of niggly fouls, hasn't there? It's not been a...
I think on the whole he's done okay, the ref.
Yeah, it's not been a vicious...
I'm happy with the Johnson challenge and the...
Yeah, it's not been a vicious
half,
game, has it?
It's terrible.
It's not been malicious fouls, it's just been little niggly fouls, hasn't it, that punctuated the game.
We'll pick it up again, 59 minutes gone in this game here on BBC Radio Lincoln. To remind you, Boston were, last we heard, 3-1 up in the FA Cup, Stamford leading as well, Grantham goalless. It has to be a result today. No replays in the FA Cup now this season. I think they'll end up sticking probably when we get back, hopefully, to normal times, whenever that will be. So it's a City free kick. George Grant on the right is on it, and he's looking to play it right-footed into the penalty area, towards the penalty spot, and it's headed away by a Blackpool defender. Jackson was there, but it just went over his head, and Blackpool looking to bring the ball away. Monsmouth blocking it off, Blackpool playing their way forward. Monsmouth's in there, great challenge from Teo Eden, wins it back. Lincoln City have it now with Jones, and now with McGrandles, and now Teo Eden, and Eden flicks it down the corner, and it rolls out of play, and that just looks wrong, Tom. There's a picture of you as Rambo, and I don't know, you look like a character from Coronation Street to me in it. I don't know.
Which Coronation Street do you watch?
Blackpool Townfield, headed away by Jackson, and then on by Johnson. Oh, and brought down by Hopper. Jones out towards the left-hand side. George Grant chests it down. George Grant pushing forward. Plays the ball sideways to his captain, Bridcutt. Bridcutt chips it inside the area. Doesn't quite find Johnson. Out on the right is Ioma. Back inside the area. Keeper spills it. Oh. Johnson goes over. Referee not interested. And Blackpool clear their lines. But there's got to be, surely, for one of these two teams, a goal in the next few minutes. They really are pushing hard, both of them.
Yeah, you keep expecting a goal, don't you? But it took some frenetic defending as Blackpool make a substitution, Michael, on the far side.
That's the sign of the times, isn't it, when it's 13-29 is the change. I remember it used to be 2-12 or something. It's Luke Garbutt coming on and replacing Bez Lubala, and it looks like it's the fullback possibly is pushing on, and Garbutt's going to have to cope with Johnson. So it's not the fullback who is struggling has been pushed further forward, Tomo.
Yeah, we'll have to see how he copes.
Sliding challenge from McGrandles. So it must be hard to come on and deal with a player who's in form.
Well, it can't be a coincidence that both left backs have been substituted.
Jackson's clearance high. Hopper is trying to get underneath it. Blackpool hook it back into the Lincoln half. Jackson heads it away. Picked up in the centre of midfield. Great challenge. Well, it's a terrific challenge from Bridker. And away comes Johnson with the ball. Suddenly sprinting forward. Pauses. Looks back and his captain's there. And Bridker spreads the ball. Lovely pass out to Grant. Great control from Lincoln's number 10. And Grant plays it back inside and he gets it from McGrandall, stretches for it just a bit too much on it and it's cleared away, back with Montsmith, he wins the header but straight to a Blackpool man. Bridcut initially wins it, Jones slides in, Lincoln starting to win the midfield battle a little bit in these last few minutes. McGrandall's now Bridcut chips it forward and Aoma chasing after it. Has the ball got too much for Aoma? No. Aoma down by the corner flag, wins the corner. And Tomo, we talk about goals changing games. I wonder about that Bridcut challenge. It can be sometimes a catalyst to a team.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I like to see him do. I mean, okay, he's made a mistake. Every player's make mistakes. But that's what I think is his best, when he's winning the ball in the midfield and being destructive and really breaking play up and then prompting play from and being the glue between the back four and the front players.
1-1 the scoreline.
My eyes aren't that good, Michael, but there's a Lincoln substitute over there.
And the ball is into the penalty area, not cleared, and I think it was Jackson who got his boot to the ball, and it's gathered in by the goalkeeper, and who looks to get Blackpool flying forward, and he bowls it too far, and Bridcut just tidies things up and clears it long, albeit out of play, back into the Blackpool half, and just the adrenaline was flowing there. And I think it might be Harry Anderson who's coming
like
on, Anderson
yeah.
from the Grandals, so perhaps George Grant slipping back into midfield, and Harry Anderson going up top, and that's two pacey players either side of Hopper.
Yeah, it's been I mean both teams have had pace, haven't they, in the right areas of the pitch.
I like the fact it's an attacking sub as well, Tom. I know that it's perhaps a bit different playing at home these days, but into the air goes the Blackpool man, and he looked to have made the most of it, but he's picked up a free kick. What about two or three paces outside of the penalty area, away to the left of the D. Chance to cause some real problems for Palmer, and from a Blackpool point of view, try and take a lead in this game. 1-1 the scoreline. George Grant replying after Hamilton scored against the Imps. 1-1. Can it change? Will Blackpool change it?
When you talk about draws or teams drawing at the moment, but it's been an entertaining 1-1, hasn't it? It's both teams trying to play the right way, playing with purpose in possession and playing with pace down the flanks.
I'm prepared to take a risk as well. It's going to be a free kick then on the left. Palmer's got his wall virtually in line with the penalty spot, but to the right of it as they defend it. The keeper on just a step off his line. And the free kick comes into the wall. Lincoln's wall holds. Johnson heads it away. Ball high, back inside the area. And it's turned wide by the attacking Blackpool player. And it remains 1-1. But last two free kicks against Lincoln City, credit the wall, they've stood strong.
Now, I love that when the wall stands firm and there's none of holding the family allowance.
Anderson looks to head it on, falls over. He'll be full of energy.
Just stay strong and be prepared to be hit wherever you get hit.
Well, a few of you might be wondering about the international duty situation. You might have missed our interview with Michael Appleton during the break and play. We'll mention that. But Lincoln will be playing next week, in case you're wondering. I know they have three players away on duty, but we'll talk a bit more about that during a break. Lincoln trying to get it forward. It was a bit forced from Jones. He was playing between the centre-halves. Edmonds chasing back now as well. Blackpool on the edge of the area. Into the box it goes. Bridcut clears. Jones takes his time. Plays it for Grant. Grant is wide. A couple of step-overs. Back to Teo Edlin. Then inside to Jones. Jones, good ball back to Grant. Grant inside. And he gets it back to Johnson. And forward comes Lincoln, and it's played out towards the right hand side. That's got too much on it for Aoma and out of play, and it's going to be a throw for Blackpool. But Tom, a quick thought about Lincoln and the international duty. Lewis is away, Elbazidi's away, Johnson's away. Lewis, because he's barely featured for Lincoln, doesn't effectively count. Michael Appleton was philosophical but clearly disappointed that Lincoln were going to be forced to play their next two games.
Lewis has barely featured, but so has the other boy. He's not been involved really, has he? Started one game, but I don't know. Whatever seems to be happening in this world at the moment, it's rules that we don't seem to understand.
Yes, for sure. Well, that means we'll have commentary on Lincoln Tuesday night and next Saturday at home against Bristol Rovers, a team I haven't had a chance to look at the score today, but they were had a bit of a sticky start to the season. It's with Blackpool, their goalkeeper, on the edge of his penalty area, who's just ambling forward, and I think if anything the wind's with him, we need to kick the ball. Straight out of play.
Shanked that one, didn't he? Completely outside of his foot.
I don't play golf very often, but that's exactly how my golf shot would go if I did play.
Just looking, Michael, I mean, Anderson's gone wide right. Hopper's obviously stayed down the middle, and it looked like...
Johnson looks more down the middle then,
doesn't
he?
Well, he's gone more into the midfield, hasn't he?
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how that works out. You're right, Anderson very much out on the right. Theo Eden loses possession. Lincoln win it back with George Grant. With two Blackpool players around, we still managed to find Jones. He's a clever player.
Yeah. He lifted it over him, didn't he?
Must be so frustrating to deal with a player like that sometimes when they're in form. Harry Anderson stabs it back to Bridcut, back to Anderson. Anderson, oh, he goes down. Free kick. Well, it was either going to be a free kick for a handball or a kick. And I just wonder if Johnson's playing as a 10 now, Tom, or just dropped him behind Hopper.
Well, we'll see when Blackpool get a goal kick or some kind of set play, because obviously Lincoln will take their defensive formation. But Anderson's definitely gone wide right, and Grant seems to have come out wide left. Hopper stayed down the middle as Blackpool prepares to put another substitute on.
Yeah, Blackpool, if it would wait for the free kick, and it looks like they are. And George Grant over this one. Three goals from set piece from penalties, albeit one from the follow-up from Harry Anderson, or Charlton player if you prefer, last week. Can he give Lincoln City the lead? Getting his second goal of the afternoon. 1-1 the scoreline to the right of the penalty spot. And he plays it into the air and the keeper gathers it in. It's one of them though. You almost sense if it maybe just bounced in front of the keeper, it could have caused him more problems with the wind and the rain. Blackpool flying forward. Hamilton wide on the right-hand side. Two Lincoln players around him. He's going backwards. City trying to deal with his threat. Eden, oh, that's terrific. Johnson into space through the centre circle. And Lincoln now have it out on the right, and Anderson can't get after that. But what about that, Tom? The left-back was charging down the right-hand side.
Total football, Michael.
Yeah. Long ball, and now this is what... Oh, he deals with it well. Eden heads it away, gets it to George Grant. Grant to Jones. I agree with you. Grant's clattered to the ground. Referee. Dear me.
Yeah, just a bit of GBH. Oh. Yeah, it looks like Johnson's just gone behind Hopper, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Playing in the pocket.
Be interesting to see how it works. We've got... change coming up for Blackpool. I didn't see the number, but 9's gone off, and he had that moment, didn't he, Yates, where he gave himself a bit of spice on the by the D and curled it past the post. And I didn't see the number of the man who's come on.
No, he's been conspicuous, I think. Yates
hasn't done enough, really. I think they should have taken Hamilton off, though.
Well, I think Michael Everson would have liked that.
Yes, I think you should do the opposition's changes for them.
Referee.
City have it back with Hopper and Grant. Back to Hopper, right down by the corner flag. Hopper looks to cross it inside the area. Blackpool headed away. Hopper closed down the space, cleared back towards the halfway line. Hamilton picks it up, going back towards his area, makes himself some space. Anderson, oh, that's terrific from Harry Anderson. Comes between two Blackpool players, wins it back. Bridcut inside the centre circle. Jones, and now it's all the way back to Jackson. And now with Montsma, the two centre-halves exchanging passes. Jackson pretty deep inside his own half, forced his way forward to the halfway line. Still going, slides it forward, finds Johnson, now out to Ayoma. City playing terrific football. Ayoma on the corner of the area, looking for the chance for the cross. Runs out of ideas, but it breaks inside for Johnson, back to Ayoma. Ayoma back into Johnson down by the byline, trying to pull it back, still holding on to it, goes over. Blackpool will clear it. City so close to finding their way through, and Blackpool put it out of play. But terrific game of football to watch. So Lincoln play some really nice football.
Yeah, very inventive. I like to see that run around the opponent's 18-yard box, where you've got bodies going forward and looking to having options on the ball.
Long punt into the Lincoln half. Jackson heads it back. Blackpool head it back at Lincoln. Monsmer comes in, wins the header. Bridcut goes up, wins the header. Steady get it forward in towards Hopper. Now Jones inside the centre circle. Bounces up. Johnson has it. He's got a runner outside in Anderson. Anderson on the right looking for the chance. He drives in the shot. Adrenaline going a bit too much and he goes over the top. Still 1-1, 18 minutes to go this game in the very much in the offing for either team to try and win it.
Well, we keep saying between us, Michael, look, there's a goal. Can we not? At the moment, you understand Lincoln being in the ascendancy.
Blackpool playing it long into the Lincoln half, and Eden does well against Hamilton that time, anticipates him and then loses him and manages pretty quickly to win it back. And City have it now with Bridcut. City in front of the back four, playing it out to the right hand side, looking for Aoma. Aoma's touch loses possession and Blackpool have won a free kick.
Yeah, been a lot of crisp passing, hasn't there, from both teams really. And both teams really, what I like, Michael, this game, both teams looking to play the ball forward as opposed to going square and back that we see when a lot of possession. It's been going forward whenever it is. Fullbacks.
Well, we have seen from Blackpool they'll win a lot more games than their current position suggests, which I don't think will surprise many people. Jones flicks it on. George Gran. Oh, he just loses possession, runs into the Blackpool man. The orange shirts, the tangerine shirts, if you prefer, have it. They get out towards the left-hand side. And they're playing it down the channel. City have got Aoma back there defending. And Lincoln looking to win it back. Great challenge from Anderson. It comes off the Blackpool man out for a... I thought it was for a City throw. It's been given as a Blackpool throw. Into the area it goes. Lincoln have got plenty of players back. Monsmer doesn't dive in with a challenge. City trying to win it back. They do with Aoma. And he clears it back towards the halfway line. Blackpool pick it off and play it back into the edge of the penalty area. City trying to win the ball back. Bridcut's back there. Good challenge from Aoma. Anderson turns and tries to clear long. Comes off a Blackpool man and the second Blackpool player puts it out of play for a throw. And are we going to get a winning goal for one of these two teams? 16 minutes to go. 1-1 the scoreline here on BBC Radio Lincolnshire. Grantham still goalless. They look to be heading towards penalties in the FA Cup. Last we heard Boston 3-1 up against Mansfield and 2-0 last I heard for Stamford.
Yeah, you would think whichever team gets the next goal would be enough to win the game with the amount of time that's ticking by.
Ball played forward and Hopper picks it up and he's got a chance. He didn't quite have enough on it, but it's picked up nevertheless by Grant. Oh, what a ball through the middle to Johnson. Can't quite control it. Breaks back for Jones and to Anderson on the right hand side. Anderson just, he does a lovely deal with the skill, wins the ball, plays it inside the air and wins a corner. Oh, it just didn't sit right. That was a glorious ball from Grant, though, Tomo, towards Johnson.
Absolutely. I mean, it just fizzed into him, Johnson, wasn't it? And he just escaped him, Johnson, on his first touch, which enabled a Blackpool defender to recover. But approach play from Lincoln has been excellent for me this afternoon.
Corner into the penalty area, headed away by a Blackpool man. Harry Anderson wins it back briefly. In comes Aoma with the challenge. Blackpool flying forward. Monsmer is back there pretty quickly. Lincoln have got bodies back. Monsmer wins it on the halfway line. Striding forward now with Grant. Lincoln pushing forward. Lincoln's fitness has told in other games. Will it tell today as Grant is fouled for a free kick?
Yeah, strong play from Monsmer there, coming in front and winning the ball. Excellent play. Being 20 yards into the Blackpool half, he could commit himself.
Getting close to the last 10 minutes. We've only got commentary Tuesday night with Rob and Tomo of Lincoln City against Mansfield. in the EFL Trophy, and then this time next week it's Bristol Rovers for us. Ball in the box, chance for Lincoln. Oh, right across the area, turned back in, and how that is not in the back of the net, I don't know. It bounced right across the 6-yard box and really should have been turned in, and City are asking more and more of the questions now. Blackpool give the ball away, Bridka has it, spins, gives it to Teo Eden. Eden looks up, Hopper makes a run, but he's not interested. Back to the danger man, Grant. And now with Eden, he chips it down the channel. It's behind the Lincoln attacking player, and Blackpool will win it back. They're looking for their way forward now as well. Really high quality game this between two very attack-minded teams.
Yeah, Lincoln for me, Michael, looking the more likely
energy
to score.
Well.
And Blackpool just struggling to get the ball forward at the moment and get options on the ball.
Michael Appleton watching as Blackpool look to force their way forward, passing it around just inside the Lincoln half. Now Lincoln have got plenty of players back. Bridka, who's been a live wire, wins the ball back and then plays it for Hopper. Hopper charging down the right-hand side, looks up, Johnson inside him. He's also got Jones making a terrific run round the right-hand side. Jones, terrific save, comes back for the number eight. Again, the shot from Anderson is palmed wide and it goes out for a corner. What attacking football from Lincoln. I think Blackpool felt that Bridcutt had committed the foul. Lincoln carried on playing and nearly carved out a second goal. Still 1-1.
Yeah, that's what I said 20 minutes ago. I said, see Bridcut doing breaking play up there, getting prompt in play. Great ball in for Jones. I mean, Jones's energy for getting forward. And it's good to see a midfield player getting forward from both behind and in front of the ball. And terrific strike and a great save from Maxwell.
Corner into the area, flicked on, loose inside the area. City can't find the player to turn it in.
I don't know how Blackpool are getting away with these corners. It's dropping in their 6-yard box. Really living on the edge.
Can City find a winner? Blackpool going to make a change. And the change is going to see their number eight, Keshi Anderson, come off and be replaced by MJ Williams.
Well, unless this substitute comes on and scores a goal, I think that's a good substitution for Lincoln, because he's been very dangerous down that left-hand side for Blackpool.
Lincoln have one left up their sleeve if they want it, but I don't think they need it at the moment. They're asking all the questions they need to. Ball bounces over Monsma's head. Blackpool breaking forward. City, though, win it back. Back towards Palmer. And that's a very emphatic clearance long. Hopper chases after it. Defender looks at Hopper, who leans into him. Comes off the defender and he has to slide and put it out for a throw instead of a corner.
Sometimes, Michael, the old-fashioned ball works.
Oh, it does, doesn't it? But Michael Appleton said that as well. He said it, occasionally we do pin it long. We don't have to always play through.
You're going to mix it up and it's the ball that's on at the time. And I mean, that was the only thing open to Lincoln with Palmer. And
cross into the penalty. There's a Lincoln player, George Grant, down inside the area. And you heard a burst of noise from certainly Grant. I didn't see too much support from his teammates. But he was down inside the area by the penalty spot. Nothing given. Blackpool coming forward. And City looking the more energetic and the more like they're going to push forward, but silly from Grant.
Could be a yellow card for Grant. That retribution
from Grant. He's shown a bit of retribution, got after the player and committed the foul.
Not too subtle, that was it?
No.
Let's count to 10.
Don't you think he's got a bit of the sort of the gait of Lallana, I think? Do you know what I mean?
If I had to compare him to a modern day player, it'd be Grealish for me.
Well, certainly a player with plenty of talent, and he's putting it on show this season in bags, getting goals, getting assists, tackling back, and he's getting yellow cards as well occasionally.
Well,
5 minutes to go.
If you take that, I mean, as long as it keeps on the pitch, but frustration, as you said, wasn't it, from me? You thought he'd won a penalty, and frustration, you can understand that.
1-1 the scoreline. You'll always have to get thinking about his man of the match in the next few minutes.
Yeah, two contenders.
Oh. Blackpool pushing forward. Turton. Moving it around inside their own half there. Blackpool, Lincoln with plenty back. Very much a 4-4 from Lincoln City with Johnson just behind Hopper. get details of a late goal in the Grantham game in a moment, but Blackpool pushing their way forward. Hamilton chases after it, Teo Edden with him, and Edden gets a good challenge in out for a corner. So what happens with this corner?
I think Edden's done a good job in the second half. He's certainly had his hands
full. He's also had to make Hamilton go the other way a little bit, hasn't he? Corner for Blackpool. You can hear the wind here in Blackpool is up. Waiting for the corner to be taken. Into the area it goes, and it's a good header away from Anderson at the near post. Blackpool drive the ball back inside the area, and it's a stooping header from McGrandles, and it bounces once, bounces twice, retrieved by a Blackpool player, lifts the ball high inside the area, bounces up, Leach Saint! Oh, Blackpool have scored! They've got their goal! City have dominated for the last 15 minutes or so, and Blackpool have suddenly scored, and isn't that football all over?
I mean, if you say anything about Lincoln this season, Michael, it's balls into the box, isn't it? The set players as well, they've not quite dealt with them, and they've had a lot of crosses in the box, and they've just not dealt with that once again, and it's fell in the box, hasn't it? And it's just a simple tapping, and it's a sucker punch, really.
It's the fullback push forward, Mitchell, who's got it. Let's get to Graham. Goal in the Grantham game.
12 minutes to go, and it's Grantham who've been opened up on their left-hand side. Ball played into the centre, back for Callum Dolan, and he fired in from 12 yards out. It's Grantham Town 0, Matlock Town 1.
Hopper barged over, referee not interested. And it's back with Blackpool on the edge of the area. City trying to win it back. Johnson does just that. Into the area he goes. Oh, that's gone over. And that is another penalty. Johnson wins his second penalty of the afternoon from sloppy play from Blackpool. And it's a red card.
Oh, a double whammy.
Is that the man who's just come on? No, it's not, is it? No. But it was brilliant from Johnson and sloppy from Blackpool. I think Blackpool in their minds were celebrating and still thinking they were the home and the host.
But once again, they're trying to play out from the back, and you've just scored, and they always say in football that you're at your most fragile when you've scored. You switch off and lose concentration. Blackpool do that, give the ball away, trying to play on the edge as you throw an 18-yard box. And Johnson again, the tormentor. And it's a double whammy for Blackpool, not only a penalty, but a sending off as well.
It's Grant. The penalty man is still walking off.
Well,
it's husband, isn't it, who's making his way off.
Well, he knows he's made a terrible, terrible error.
Well, in the first half, we had Johnson win the penalty, and we had Grant convert it. Johnson's won the penalty, other end of the ground. Upsets Lincoln's number 10, George Grant. Can he level things here? 2-1 at the moment for Blackpool. Steps up. Takes it right footed and scores! Lincoln City have levelled it, and they're rushing City Field in 6 minutes. They can find another and win this game.
Well, they've got the extra man as well, haven't they? And Blackpool, feeling sorry for themselves, scored a goal, and then within a minute find themselves back level on 2-2, and really of their own doing.
Shall we get the statos going to check something?
If you like.
Do you know what I'm going to ask you? When was the last time a Lincoln player scored a hat-trick from penalties?
I wouldn't have a clue, Michael.
I can't imagine anyone's ever done it, have they? I think Chris Ashton's probably just spat out his porridge and having a quick look. Somebody will know. Well beyond me. I don't think I've ever commentated on it, so it's at least 25 years ago.
I don't
ago.
Think I've ever played in it or seen
so
it,
that's
to be
at
honest.
Least 50 years ago.
And the rest.
City then, with a man advantage, 5 minutes to go plus stoppage time. Can they find a winning goal? Back with Teo Edden. It's a run from Harry Anderson. That's what I like to see, these little darting runs there, asking questions of Blackpool. Bridcut plays the long ball downfield. Teo Edden plays it in. Aoba plays it into Harry Anderson. Anderson to look to try and get the cross in, or at least win a corner. Breaks back for Anderson. And I think it's Aoba who's won it. He has. He's come away with the ball. Playing inside to Jones. Jones makes himself some space. Back into Aoba on the right-hand side. First time ball inside the area. Breaks up on Johnson. And the ball's cleared away downfield. And we've got 4 minutes to go.
Yeah, I suspect it's going to be desperate defending from Blackpool. Lincoln really throwing bodies forward. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, they've given the ball away, Tomo. And Blackpool coming forward. 1 against 2. Bridker's going to slide in and win the ball. Does extremely well, the Lincoln City captain. I like to see that from him. And that was overplaying in the wrong position for Lincoln. But that's good from City. They're coming forward, Eden, out towards Grant, back to Eden, very central from him. Can he find a way through? Out towards the left-hand side, and Hopper, there are players inside, in towards Jones. Defender makes the run, and it kicks it out of play. He did all the work, and then he kicked it out of play. And last week, Tomo, Charlton made a mistake, gave away a corner, and Lincoln scored. Are we going to see Monsma do the same?
Well, this game, it's been topsy-turvy, hasn't it? And the Blackpool centre-back, he's trying to be too clever there. He's trying to run it out of play and inadvertently put it out of play for a corner.
3 minutes plus stoppage time to go. Probably 3 or 4 minutes of that. 2-2 the scoreline. Grant into the penalty area, back post. Jackson does a diving header. Bounces up loose. Monsma! Yeah, he's done it! City are 3-2 up. Monsma's fifth goal of the season. Would you believe it?
He writes his rights, he's on scripts, that boy.
Oh, dear me, Tom. I thought 5 minutes ago that was it, done and dusted. What a game of football.
Well, I mean, the Blackpool manager will have to restrain himself from his player who got sent off, won't he? Because, really, he's at fault for the defeat for me. He's got caught, he's given a penalty where he got sent off. And then also the centre-back from Blackpool, who could have just cleared the ball and gave a corner away, and Monsma's cashed in on it. And
well, what a great game of football. You wouldn't rule out another one now, would you, the way the game's gone?
Well, we found ourselves earlier this season saying that Lincoln keeping clean sheets and being really tight and solid, and now we've had a game of 3-2.
Come from
3-2.
Behind twice and winning 3-2. If you're wondering at home nervously, 2 minutes plus stoppage time. I'm going to go for 3, maybe 4 minutes to stoppage time. Harry Anderson away from one. Harry Anderson charging forward, straight through the middle, hacked down. And that's going to be a free kick. And Harry Anderson doing exactly what I'm sure his manager wants him to do, just run with the ball and make them make the challenge.
Yeah, it's just a case, really. Now, Lincoln keeping the discipline, not doing anything silly.
Terrific character from the Lincoln City players this afternoon.
How can I say? I don't understand why Bridcut has to be that far back looking to take the kick. The referee's given the Lincoln the hurry up.
So having a little look. Ipswich are drawing, and Hull City, who are level on points with Lincoln City. I can't find the score at the moment. I'll look for that in a second. Hopper has it to Grant. Slides it inside. Blackpool have won it back, trying to clear it away downfield. Playing it to the halfway line. Only one player forward. Monsma wins it. Jackson through the middle. Gives the ball away. Gets a second bite of the cherry. Harry Anderson shields it. Anderson away from one man. Striding forward on the corner of the air. Drives in the shot over the top.
It's got to be said, Anderson's had a
impact, hasn't he?
And the impact coming on, he's got down that right hand side and used his pace. And as we said, he's become a better player, hasn't he, this season? A bit more guile to his game.
I know it's early days, Tomo, but Lincoln are top. As you stand. I think you'd take it any day of the week, wouldn't you?
Absolutely.
George Grant back to Eden, and Eden playing it all the way back to Palmer. And I think he's had, even though he's conceded to, I think he's had a good afternoon considering the conditions around here, so how much wind and rain there is around. 4 minutes of stoppage time for Blackpool to find a goal to level it.
Yeah, it's a tough one for a man of the match as well.
Well, it's only you got to decide it. So.
Yeah, I mean, Johnson's done well, Grant's done well.
Blackpool pushing forward, a man down.
Bridcut.
Lincoln have won it back though. Jackson looks up, not many players ahead of him moving. Now he slides it forward to Hopper and to Aoma on the halfway line. Back to Monsma. Monsma plays a high ball over the top. Blackpool going backwards. I didn't think for a second seen that Grant was trying to run through. It's back with the goalkeeper. City 3-2 up here on BBC Radio Lincolnshire. 3 minutes to play. Grant slides in, but it's going to be Turton who brings it away. Blackpool looking for a way back into this game. A man down, the wind is to their backs as they have it on the halfway line. 3 minutes to go on 94.9 FM. Slid forward for Blackpool. Lincoln got players around it. Bounces off Aoma. Bit of a tired idea for me, that, from the Blackpool player who was short of space, and it comes off him out for a throw. And City are 3-2 up here.
You can see why Blackpool have not won more games, Michael, can't you? But there's a fragility about them, isn't there, at the back for me?
I think once again, I know they've got the man advantage all of a sudden, but Lincoln have looked, that's a foul on Johnson, but Lincoln have looked the fitter team again. Not quite as marked as perhaps the other games, but still looked sharper.
Yeah, I mean, although Lincoln have conceded two goals, I mean, they're two poor goals. One was a giveaway, one, and one was from a cross. They do look more solid, organised. Blackpool, to me, as I said, there's a fragility about them, and that is a word, thank
you. 2 minutes. No, fragility is a word. 2 minutes to go. Harry Anderson down by the corner flag, looking to win a corner or keep the ball in the by the corner, and he plays it into the Blackpool player, and it goes out of play.
You're going to push me for a man of the match, aren't you?
There you go.
It's going to be a little bit controversial, this one, I think, just for a change.
I'm dreading to think where you're going. Still fighting for the ball, by the way, down by the corner flag. It's gone out for a goal kick, a minute and a half to go.
I'm going, I mean, Grant's done well, Johnson's done well, but I'm going for Bridcut, because although he's given a goal away and really put his team under pressure,
His challenge got them going, didn't it?
Well, he's one of those players, he doesn't hide.
That's terrible for Blackpool. Bridcut wins it back. Johnson has it, looks up. And Lincoln don't need to spread forward in too many numbers. They can just hold on to it here. They've got a minute left. We'll come back to you in a second, Tom, when we get a break in play. Aoma through the middle. He's got Harry Anderson outside of him. Anderson out wide. Lincoln not committing too many forward. But Anderson's going to go and do his best impersonation of Matt Reed and try and sit on the ball and win a throw, and he at least wins a throw down by the corner flag. And Blackpool looking a tired team, 40 seconds to go.
Yeah, I'll just explain my decision in Bridcut is that, I mean, once you give the goal away, some players go and hide and feel sorry for themselves and don't want the ball, but he's just prompted, as you said, he's won the ball for the second goal or the penalty. He's kept Lincoln going, he's won some important challenges. When the ball was given away 5 or 10 minutes ago, he won that challenge, and I just think he's been a big influence on his team, both leading it as the captain and on the pitch. And Grant, as I said, Grant's done well, Johnson's done well, but I just think Bridcut over 90 minutes has played a massive captain's part for me.
Blackpool are trying to get the game going, but they're kicking the ball when it's moving, and we now have played 4 minutes of stoppage time. Is Monsma going to be the match winner for Lincoln City with a couple of goals for George Grant? Referee blasts on his whistle, and that is a fantastic win for Lincoln City. Twice behind to Blackpool, but penalties from George Grant. One by Brennan Johnson, got it level. Then Blackpool, with the second penalty, had a man sent off. Lincoln made the most of it. A corner finally told. Monsma with his fifth of the season. Lincoln with 3 points. Lincoln remain 100% this season in the league.
An excellent game for me in difficult conditions, and both teams trying to play on the deck and through the midfield and down the flanks. It's been a good game of football. At one time, you know, it looked like teams could score at will, but Lincoln have had two penalties, and they were penalties, and they've shown great character. There's a good resilience about Lincoln, a good togetherness, and they've got pace in the right areas of the pitch.
Yeah, absolutely, Tomo. Let's talk about the back four. I mean, let's do the negatives first, the two goals conceded. The first one, as you said, look, you've given Liam Bridcut the man of the match, but it was him who was at fault for the first goal.
Yeah, and he'll need telling, but he won't need telling, if you understand. I mean, he'll know as an experienced player that he's made a big mistake there. But he's trying to play on from the edge of his own 18-yard box, and a silly pass that's cost his team a goal.
And the second of the goals came from a corner, and it felt a bit against the run of play. Lincoln had probably had the sort of 10 minutes before it, but Blackpool got their goal, and I think they got a bit carried away from that moment, didn't they?
Yeah, just It just worries me a little bit. They've conceded a few too many from set plays and crosses, Lincoln, and Mark Appleton will know that. He'll be working on it. But it's a poor goal to concede. And then just when you think 2-1, I mean, the Blackpool player makes a complete hash of it, gives it away, gives a penalty away and gets himself sent off. But Lincoln still have to go and win it, and that's what they did. They just believed in themselves and went on and won the game.
We're not going to see Johnson next week. He's going to be away on international duty. He could be playing, as I said, at Wembley next week for Wales against England. That would be an amazing moment for him. But today, you know what we've seen from him, he's going to be a very useful weapon for Lincoln, isn't he?
Yeah, he's got. He's another one. You see the pace he's got, but it's the fast feet he's got when he gets one-on-one and he gets past players. Very direct, knows what he's going to do, attacks the goal, doesn't attack the corner flag. And having said that, when Michael Appleton made his substitute, you thought, well, if Harry Anderson's coming on, Johnson's going off. But no, he put Johnson up alongside or just behind Hopper, and Harry Anderson come on and had an enterprising 20 minutes or so.
So 100% record, Tomo. I mean, it's been a very good start to the season, to say the least.
Yeah, and as I said, the big thing for me and the part and parcel of it is that there's a good togetherness within the team, and there's that never-say-die attitude from the players, and they've got pace in the right areas now. They've got Johnson, they've got Anderson, they've got the midfield player, James Jones, that looked like he can get forward from the midfield into the box. The results suggest that it's looking very, very good. And I was saying, they're making themselves a hard team to beat and a hard team to score against. Obviously, you're not happy when you concede two goals, but you get games like this where you win it and you just say, OK, we let two bad goals in, but we've won the game.
And threats all around the park. You know, a centre-half is on 5 goals already this season.
Yeah, unbelievable. And he's got that knack. There was many years ago, there was a player, Derek Mountfield, Everton, I think, as a centre-back. He got 14 one season in the Premier League. But Monsema, whenever he goes up there, looks like he believes he can score. I mean, he had a lot of time to put it in, but it doesn't matter. I mean, he was up there, he scored the goal, and Michael Appleton, delighted. I mean, he had a big ghost to lay, didn't he? And he's making an excellent fist of it.
Absolutely. More from Tomo in the last hour of the programme here on BBC Radio Lincolnshire. So, Lincoln City 3-2 win this afternoon, having been 2-1 down with 3 or 4 minutes to go. Fantastic response from the players. Let's get to the North Hope for a home game of Boston United in the FA Cup with Rob.
Yeah, Boston United making it through to the third qualifying round draw on Monday lunchtime. Wasn't the perfect performance, though. They beat Mansfield by 4-2. 2 goals in 2 minutes opening the scoring for Boston. Tap-ins for Terry Hawkridge and Jordan Burrow opening their Boston United accounts. Carcash pulling a goal back for AFC Mansfield midway through that first half. They then hit the post through striker Ross Duggan, who caused Boston issues all afternoon. But Boston